after Easter, after having been through the worst kind of terror and uncertainty and grief and not knowing, after having what they thought were all their hopes dashed, and then the surprise of Easter Day, of tombstones rolled away and angels in robes like lightning perched on top, kicking their feet as impertinent as you like, the surprise of where there should have been a body being only emptiness. After Easter and seeing Jesus, finally the disciples went home. They went back to Galilee, back to regular life, back to where the world waited for them as they had always known it. And now they were back after Easter. And back there at home, they remembered what Jesus had said. Because at some point as they were walking along, Jesus pointed to a mountain and said, "Go there. I'll be there for you." And they climbed up the mountain, and there Jesus was. Jesus, now their risen Lord, Jesus, back in the areas and the life where they knew, and some of them fell on their faces and worshiped him. Some of them doubted, and I'll bet every single one of them had a whole mess of questions that they would love to ask this risen Lord. And gathered with them on top of the mountain this time after Easter, Jesus had a commandment for them, a commission, and a promise. Because that's how Jesus works. He gives us work to do and gives us the promise that'll get us through it and help us with it. And in one word, in one command, he reached way back to the beginnings of God's time with God's people. What God has been doing since the beginning of time, all the way back through Moses and the Red Sea and the time in the wilderness, back through the prophets, back to Abraham, and even further to Adam, to this vision of God kneeling in the dirt, shaping and forming the clay and breathing his Holy Spirit life into him. Since the beginning, God has been shaping people. All of Israel, their history is of God shaping a people for the sake of the world that all may come to know. We heard it in Isaiah, God who creates all things, shaping his people and giving them as a covenant, a promise for the whole world. So Jesus reaches back and in line summarizes God's great work in the world and gives them a commission and says, go. Go. Go and make disciples of all nations for the sake of the whole world. Go and make disciples and baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And sisters and brothers, that's us. We are the ones who are the inheritors of this commission because we are the ones that somebody sought out. Somebody came to us, whether we were this big or this big, somebody came and said, "I want you to know about this Jesus that I've come to know." Somebody in our lives has invited us to know who God is and given us the privilege of knowing and serving and following. We are the disciples who've been made by this commission. But more than that, sisters and brothers, or alongside that, we're also the ones who have that commission to go that others may know how much God loves them, to go and make disciples, to share and shape faith. And every time we gather around our young people at baptism, or our not-so-young people, every time we gather at the table, every time we read the Bible, and every time we pray, God is shaping us. Now, last fall, we had the chance to gather in what we called Holy Conversations. It was a time for us to listen together for the work of the Holy Spirit in our midst, listening together for what is God doing, and those sort of sparks, we call them, the little sparks of life that the Holy Spirit works in us, that as God is doing things, we see those sparks of life, and we had that chance to listen. We gathered them, we prayed over them, and recently your council, your leadership in the congregation has been praying on them and praying about what our future together looks like. What is it that God has in mind for us? From what we have said together and what the Holy Spirit has been saying into our midst, your council has become convinced that this idea of shaping faith at the heart of who we are is where God intends us to put our focus right now. That this idea of shaping ourselves, our kids, and our grown-ups in faith and in being disciples is where God is sending the Holy Spirit to tug us and draw us forward. And as a council, as your leaders, we are so excited to see what God is going to do with this. And the vision that we've come to, that's come to us in prayer, is the idea of all of us going together to we worship together as the body of Christ here. And then we study together as the body of Christ here. Just as we pray together as the body of Christ here. And we serve together as the body of Christ here. This idea of all of us being shaped from this age to this age, together being shaped and formed in faith, is something that we feel like God is clearly blessing us toward. And we can't wait to see what God is going to do with that. And so today we have an invitation for you, an invitation to Holy Conversations. It's an opportunity for us to listen together for how God has shaped us in faith, about our own stories, about God's presence in our days and our lives, how we came to know who Jesus is and how we became disciples, how along that journey God has been shaping and equipping and forming us. It's a chance to share nothing more than our own experiences, what God has been doing in your life, and a chance to listen together for how God might be shaping us toward his future. And so in just a moment, I'm going to say, go. And when I do, the invitation is to find a reasonably friendly-looking stranger. So ideally, somebody you don't know, somebody that you know a little less than others, somebody that is an opportunity to get to know someone, and you've received a little yellow sheet that has three questions on it. It's an opportunity to listen to each other's story. So ask those questions of each other. Hear each other's story. You're going to be jotting down notes of what your partner, conversation partner, says. And then on the back, anything that comes to mind about your hopes, how you would dream, the things that you're noticing in common, the future that you sense together, and what it might mean for you. You can read the questions as many times as you wish, lead some silence to think about it, but above all, you're sharing your own experience. Now, a couple notes. One is, if you have young people with you, we are so glad. And we don't want you to feel like you are being abandoned in this, because we would love to have them as conversation partners in this too. God speaks through our young people, and we need to hear that as well. So if we have younger ones here, they can be alongside and in that conversation. Second thing is, for our guests that are here, we don't want you to be, well, actually, we're going to invite you to be as uncomfortable in this as we are, because not a one of us is used to this. This is something new, and it involves talking about God and stuff like that. So we are just as uncomfortable with this as you are, but always, 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 we remember that when Jesus gives us a commandment, he gives us a promise to get us through. And do you remember what that commandment was at the very end of that gospel? It's the very end of the whole gospel of Matthew. After Jesus says, go, he says, remember, I am with you always through the end of the age. So whenever we're uncomfortable and invited to step out beyond what we're used to, and whenever we're invited to be shaped and formed in faith, and whenever we're invited in a time to, that God might work in us, we're given this promise that it is Jesus who is with us. As we talk, as we listen, as we come to know each other, it is Jesus who is moving through us. So, in just a moment, as I say go, hold fast to that promise. It is Jesus who is with us. And so as we get ready, let us pray together. Lord God, you have claimed us as your people, given us the gift of your love, and sent us to share with the world. Bless our conversations today with your Holy Spirit. Guide us and speak in us and through us. Lord, we love you, and we long to know you more. Use our time today to guide us as we grow in faith. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Ready? Go. A reasonably friendly-looking stranger.